Sergius Paulus wanted to hear God's message, and he sent for Barnabas and Saul. But Bar-Jesus, whose other name was Elymas, was against them. He even tried to keep the governor from having faith in the Lord. Then Saul, better known as Paul, was filled with the Holy Spirit. He looked straight at Elymas and said, "You son of the devil, you are a liar, a crook, and an enemy of everything that is right. When will you stop speaking against the true ways of the Lord? The Lord is going to punish you by making you completely blind for a while." Suddenly the man's eyes were covered by a dark mist, and he went around trying to get someone to lead him by the hand. When the governor saw what had happened, he was amazed at this teaching about the Lord. So he put his faith in the Lord. And those words come from Acts 13, verses 7 to 12. When you think of miracles, you usually think of the deaf becoming able to hear, the lame being able to walk, the dead being raised, and the blind regaining their sight. But these verses tell the story of a man who could see, becoming temporarily blind because of the power of God. That is also what happened to Paul himself on the road to Damascus. Sometimes God must take away our vision before he can truly restore our sight. It is a little like the time-out discipline of a child. We are not told if Elymas ever came to have faith in Jesus, but the governor, who saw the reverse miracle, did. I believe God still does this same reverse miracle today. When you oppose Jesus, he makes you spiritually blind. As a self-proclaimed and active enemy of God, you are like a blind man standing before a sunset. You may sense that the day is almost done because the air is getting cooler, but you will never see the glory of the sunset until you turn your heart to Jesus.